Hi, welcome back to my class in Differential Calculus or Calculus 1. In the last lesson, we had more examples for obtaining the derivatives of functions. But in obtaining the derivatives of the functions, we use the definition of derivative. That is, we obtain the derivatives of functions using limits. But this way of finding the derivatives of function using the definition of derivative or using limits becomes a tedious and lengthy process. But we have differentiation rules to simplify the process of finding the derivatives of functions. In using these differentiation rules, we are guided on how to find the derivatives of functions in just a matter of seconds. So here are the differentiation rules. The first differentiation rule is for the derivative of a constant function. In number one, the function y is equal to k. That means our function is a constant function. Y is a function of independent variable x, but for any value of the independent variable x, the value of y is k. So this y equals k is a constant function. And the derivative of a constant function denoted by y prime equals 0. If the function is equal to any constant, the derivative of any constant is 0. The second differentiation rule is known as the power rule. Here we have the function y equals x to the power n. And the derivative of x to the power n denoted by y prime is equal to n, the exponent of x, multiplied by x, less 1 from the original exponent of x, n. Again, the derivative of x to the n denoted by y prime. Y prime denotes the derivative of y with respect to x. Is equal to n, the original exponent of x, multiplied by x to the power n minus 1. And this second differentiation rule is known as the power rule. In number 3, we have a function equal to the product of a constant and a function. And according to this differentiation rule, the derivative of a constant times a function is equal to the constant times the derivative of the function f. There should be f prime here. Again, the third differentiation rule is for the derivative of a constant times a function. And the derivative of a constant times a function denoted by y prime is equal to the constant times the derivative of the function f, denoted by f prime of x. F prime of x denotes the derivative of f, the constant the function f with respect to x. The fourth differentiation rule is known as the sum rule and difference rule in one. In number 4, we have the derivative of the sum or difference of two functions, y equals f of x plus the function g of x, or y equals the difference of the function f of x and the function g of x. And according to this differentiation rule, the derivative of a sum or difference of two functions, f of x and g of x, denoted by y prime, is equal to the sum or difference of the derivatives of the two functions. If you have the sum of f of x and g of x, its derivative is equal to the sum of the derivative of f and the derivative of g. If you have the function y equals f of x minus g of x, that is y equals the difference of two functions, then the derivative of that function denoted by y prime is the difference of the derivatives of the two functions, or derivative of f with respect to x minus derivative of g with respect to x. The fifth differentiation rule is known as the product rule, because this differentiation rule applies when you have a product of two functions, f of x and g of x. If the function y equals the product of the function f of x and g of x, then the derivative of y with respect to x, denoted by y prime, equals the function f of x times the derivative of g of x, denoted by g prime of x, plus, this is always plus the derivative of the function f of x denoted by f prime of x multiplied by derivative of g of x. The fifth differentiation rule is known as the product rule. In number 6, we have a rational function that is a quotient of two functions, f of x and g of x. And this, the derivative of the quotient of f of x and g of x denoted by y prime is equal to, the denominator is the square of the denominator in the original rational function or rational expression, the function in the denominator, and you get the square of it, and you have the denominator of the derivative of y with respect to x. In the numerator, we have the function g of x, the denominator in the given quotient, multiplied by the derivative of f with respect to x, the derivative of the function in the numerator, denoted by f prime of x, minus, this is always minus, the function f of x, the function in the numerator, multiplied by the derivative of g with respect to x, denoted by g prime. G prime of x is the derivative of the function in the quotient, or the function in the denominator. And this sixth differentiation rule is known as the quotient rule. Number 7 is known as the chain rule. The function y is a function of u, but u here is a function of g of x. And if we want the derivative of y with respect to x, denoted by dy dx, dy dx denotes the derivative of y with respect to x. And it's equal to the derivative of the function f with respect to u, because f is a function of u. But u is a function of g of x, thus we multiply the derivative of f with respect to u by the derivative of u, which is the derivative of g with respect to x. Again, this is the seventh differentiation rule, is known as the chain rule. Number 8, we have the derivative of an exponential function where the base is a constant e, irrational number e, raised to a variable x. And the derivative of y equals e to the x, denoted by y prime, is e to the x. This is easy to remember. The derivative of e to the x is itself e to the x. But if the exponent of x, sorry, if the exponent of the base e is not x, suppose the exponent of e is u, which is a function of x, then if y equals e to the u, and u is a function of x, if the exponent of e is simply x, exponent is 1, the coefficient of x is 1, the derivative of e to the x is itself e to the x. But if you have a function y equals e to the u, where u is a function of x, then we apply the chain rule. The derivative now of y equals e to the u, denoted by y prime, equals e to the u. Derivative of e to the u with respect to u, by this differentiation rule number 8, e to the u. And because u is a function of g of x, we apply the chain rule. We multiply e to the u by derivative of u with respect to x. That is the derivative of g with respect to x. Or we write derivative of u with respect to x. The last three differentiation rules that we will apply today are the derivatives of the first three of the six basic trigonometric functions. In number 10, we have the derivative of the sine function, sine of x. The derivative of sine is cosine. In number 11, we have the derivative of y equals cosine x. The derivative of cosine x denoted by y prime equals negative sine x. In number 12, we have the derivative of the tangent function y equals tangent x. The derivative of tangent x denoted by y prime is, sorry, this is secant squared x. Again, the derivative of tangent x denoted by y prime equals secant squared x, or the square of secant x. Now, these last three differentiation rules apply only when the exponent of x is 1, the coefficient of x is 1. If sine is a function of u, and u is, if the angle of sine is a variable or a function of x other than x, then we have to apply the chain rule. You have to remember all of these differentiation rules, and we will now apply them in obtaining the derivatives of functions. For our examples, consider the following examples. Find y prime. To find y prime means to find the derivative of the given function y with respect to x. And to find y prime, we now apply the differentiation rules we had earlier. In number 1, the given function y equals 2 times the root of pi. Pi is an irrational real number and pi is a constant. And the root of pi is a constant, multiplied by 2 is a constant. Therefore, 2 times the square root of pi is a constant. And by the first differentiation rule we had earlier, the derivative of a constant function is 0. Or the derivative of any constant is 0. Since 2 times square root of pi is a constant, then this implies the derivative of y denoted by y prime is 0. In number 2, the given function y equals 3 multiplied by x raised to 5. To find the derivative of this function, we apply the second differentiation rule, the rule for the product of a constant multiplied by a function. And according to this differentiation rule, the derivative of a constant times the function denoted by y prime is equal to the constant. The constant here is the coefficient of x to the 5, 3, multiplied by the derivative of x raised to 5. To get the derivative of x raised to 5, we apply the power rule. And the power rule says if the function y equals x to the n, the derivative of y denoted by y prime is equal to n, the exponent of x, multiplied by x to the power n minus 1. We subtract 1 from the original exponent of x, n. So, to get the derivative of x raised to 5, we apply this power rule, where the exponent n is 5, Hence, the derivative of x raised to 5 equals n, which is 5, multiplied by x to the power n minus 1. And our n, the exponent n here in the power rule is 5, 5 minus 1. And we simplify. We have 3 multiplied by 5 is 15. And 5 minus 1 is 4. Multiplied, this is 3 multiplied by 5 is 15. Multiplied by x to the power 5 minus 1 is 4. Thus, the derivative of y equals 3x raised to 5, denoted by y prime, is 15x raised to 4. Number 3, we have the given function y is a function of the independent variable t. And y equals 5t cubed minus 1 half t squared plus t minus 3 over 5. To get the derivative of y with respect to t, or we simply denote the derivative of y by y prime, we apply the differentiation rule for the derivative of a sum or difference of functions. We also apply the differentiation rule for the product of a constant and a function. And we apply the power rule to get the derivative of t cubed and t squared and t. And we also apply the derivative of a constant, which is zero. So for the first term, to apply the differentiation rule for the derivative of a sum or difference of functions, we simply get the derivative of each term. And we start with the first term, we get the derivative of 5t cubed. According to the differentiation rule, for the derivative of a constant times a function, the derivative of a constant times a function is equal to the constant 5 multiplied by the derivative of the function. The function here is t cubed. And to get the derivative of t cubed, we apply the power rule. But our variable is not x in example 3. Our variable is t. But the exponent n is 3. So the derivative of t cubed equals n, the exponent of t, 3, multiplied by t. In the power rule, the variable is x. That's why n is multiplied by x to the power n minus 1. Our n, the original exponent of t, is 3. 3 minus 1. Subtract, always subtract 1 from the exponent. 3 minus 1. Minus, again we apply the differentiation rule for the product of a constant and a function. According to the rule, the derivative of a product of a constant and a function is equal to the constant 1 half multiplied by the derivative of t squared. To get the derivative of t squared, we apply again the power rule, where the exponent n now is 2 and the variable x is t. So the derivative of t squared by this power rule is equal to the exponent n. The exponent of t is 2 multiplied by the variable t, multiplied by the variable to the power n minus 1. And our n in the second term is 2 minus 1. Plus the derivative of t. The exponent of t here is 1, and applying the power rule, the derivative of t is equal to n, n is 1, multiplying by the variable is t, to the power n minus 1, n is 1. So, n is 1 minus 1. And for the last term, we apply the first differentiation rule, the derivative of a constant function. And according to that rule, the derivative of any constant is 0. And 3 over 5 is a constant. Or you can say negative 3 over 5 is a constant. Hence, the derivative of negative 3 over 5 is 0. You write 0 plus 0. Or you can write minus 0. If you want, minus times the derivative of 3 over 5 is 0. But I took the derivative of negative 3 over 5. And negative 3 over 5 is still a constant and its derivative is 0. So I wrote plus 0. Now we simplify each term. Y prime now is equal to 5 multiplied by 3 is 15. Multiply by t to the power 3 minus 1 is 2. And here, minus 1 half multiplied by 2 is 1, or 2 over 2 is 1. Multiply by 1 is 1. Multiply by t, or you simply cancel out 2. You get 1 times t is t to the power t minus 1 to the power 2 minus 1 is 1. And it's customary that when the exponent of the variable is 1, we no longer write the exponent 1. So we simply write t plus, here we have 1, multiplying by t to the power 1 minus 1 is 0. And t to the power 0, by property of exponent, is 1. As long as the base t is not 0. So this term simplifies to simply 1 times 1 is 1. And plus 0 will give us the same quantity. This is now the derivative. The derivative of y equals 5t cubed minus 1 half t squared plus t minus 3 over 5 is 15t squared minus t plus 1. For our fourth example, consider the following. Again, we find y prime, or the derivative of y with respect to the independent variable. Okay, number 4, the independent variable is x, and the given function y equals 2 divided by or over quantity 3x squared minus 1 raised to 3, or to the power 3. So the given function is a rational function. We have the quotient of a constant function, and this function, the cube of 3x squared minus 1. To get the derivative of y, you may use the quotient rule, because we have the quotient of two functions, the constant function and this function, the cube of 3x squared minus 1. But since the function in the numerator is a constant function, we can find the derivative of this in an easier way by taking the denominator to the numerator and applying the property of exponent. And we will do that. We take 3x squared minus 1 cubed to the numerator. And the property of exponent says that whenever you bring a quantity, an exponential expression in the numerator, to the denominator, or from the denominator to the numerator, we take the opposite sign of the exponent. So y prime, so y, the given function y equals 2 multiplied by 3x squared minus 1. To the power negative 3. The exponent of 3x squared minus 1 becomes negative 3 because we brought this to the numerator. And when we bring this to the numerator, we have to take the opposite sign of the exponent. Now, to get the derivative of this, we apply the differentiation rule for the product of a constant and the function. The constant is 2 and the function is quantity 3x squared minus 1 to the power negative 3. So the derivative of y using this is equal to 2 times the derivative of 3x squared minus 1 to the power negative 3. To get the derivative of quantity 3x squared minus 1 to the negative 3, we cannot readily apply the power rule, which says that the derivative of x to the n denoted by y prime is equal to the exponent n of x multiplied by x raised to n minus 1. This power rule applies only when the base is a single variable x. The coefficient of x is 1. Single variable is raised to an exponent. The base is a single variable with coefficient of 1. But here, in this function 3x squared minus 1 to the negative 3, the base of negative 3 is not just a single variable, but an algebraic expression, a binomial, 3x squared minus 1. So to get the derivative of 3x squared minus 1 to the negative 3, we apply the chain rule. And in the chain rule, we have y, the given function y is a function of u, but u is a function of x. And we want the derivative of y with respect to x. And that derivative denoted by y prime is equal to derivative of f with respect to u, df du, multiplied by derivative of u with respect to x, denoted by du dx. But the question is, in this expression, 3x squared minus 1 to the power negative 3, what is our u? We let u equals 3x squared minus 1. 3x squared minus 1. And we get the derivative of u with respect to x, because we need that in the chain rule. Derivative of u with respect to x. Derivative of 3x squared is, to get the derivative of 3x squared, we apply the differentiation rule for the product of a constant and a function. And that rule says that the derivative of a constant multiplied by a function is equal to the constant 3 times the derivative of x squared. For the derivative of x squared, we apply the power rule, where the exponent n is 2. Hence, the derivative of x squared is n, the exponent of x, 2, multiplied by x to the power n minus 1. N is the original exponent of x, 2, minus 1. And this simplifies to 3 multiplied by 2 is the derivative of 3x squared is 3 times the derivative of x squared, 2x to the power 2 minus 1. minus the derivative of 1 is 0. Let me write that. Minus the derivative of 1, because 1 is a constant, its derivative is 0. Minus 0. And this simplifies to 3 multiplied by 2 is 6. Multiply by x to the power 2 minus 1 is 1. Hence, the exponent of x is 1. But if the exponent of the variable is 1, it is customary that we no longer write the exponent 1. Minus 0, 6x minus 0 equals 6x. Hence, this becomes y now is now equal to 2. And we let 3x squared minus 1, 3x squared minus 1, we let it be equal to u to the power negative 3. So we get the derivative of y now with respect to x, denoted by y prime. In the chain rule, your f of u is now 2u to the negative 3, where u in the chain rule is equal to 3x squared minus 1. And according to the chain rule, if y equals f of u, a function of u, its derivative with respect to x equals derivative of f with respect to u. We get the derivative of this with respect to u, and we apply the differentiation rule for the derivative of a constant times same function. According to that differentiation rule, the derivative of a constant times the function equals the constant to multiply by the derivative of u to the minus 3. And to get the derivative of u to the minus 3, we apply the product rule, where the variable x is u and the exponent n is negative 3. Hence, the derivative of u to the minus 3 is equal to n negative 3. Multiply by the variable is u, to the power n minus 1. Our n is minus 3, minus 3, minus 1. Minus 3, minus 1. And because u is a function of x, specifically u is equal to 3x squared minus 1, by chain rule, we multiply the derivative of this to u to the minus 3, which is equal to this, by the derivative of u with respect to x, which is equal to derivative of u with respect to x equals 6x. Hence, we multiply this by 6x. And we simplify. Multiply the numerical coefficients. We have 3 by negative 3. Sorry, we have positive 2 by negative 3 is negative 6. Multiply by positive 6 is negative 36. Multiply by x. Multiply by u. To the power negative 3 minus 1 is negative 4. And in the final answer, we always remove the negative exponents. So we bring u to the minus 4 in the denominator. And when we do that, we take the opposite sign of the exponent negative 4. This is now equal to negative 36x. Negative 36x divided by, we now bring u to the minus 4 in the denominator, but we take the opposite sign of the exponent, negative 4. And we get u to the positive 4. And we replace u to give the answer in the original variable x. We now replace u with 3x squared minus 1. Therefore, the derivative y prime of this function 2 over 3x squared minus 1 to the power 3 equals negative 36x. Negative 36x over u. We let u equals 3x squared minus 1. 3x squared minus 1. And that quantity raised to the power 4. This is the derivative of the given function y equals 2 over 3 quantity 3x squared minus 1 to the power 3. Its derivative is denoted by y prime, and y prime equals negative 36 over quantity 3x squared minus 1 raised to 4. Consider again our last example, the fourth example. Y equals 2 over quantity 3x squared minus 1 to the power 3. We can simplify the process of obtaining the derivative of this function. We do as in the first step we did earlier. We bring this expression in the numerator by applying the property of exponent. Hence, the given function y equals 2 multiplied by quantity 3x squared minus 1 to the power negative 3. Because we brought this quantity to the numerator, we take the opposite sign of positive 3, it becomes negative 3. Now, we apply the chain rule directly to this expression by treating this quantity 3x squared minus 1 as a single variable. But in your mind, you keep in your mind that that single variable is actually 3x squared minus 1. So we get the derivative of y denoted by y prime, and by differentiation rule for the product of a constant and a function, it says the derivative of a constant and a function is equal to the constant 2. Times the derivative of 3x squared minus 1 to the negative 3. Where we apply the chain rule by the chain rule and the power rule. By treating this quantity 3x squared minus 1 as a single variable. Hence, the derivative of 3x squared minus 1 to the negative 3 by power rule is equal to the exponent, negative 3, multiplied by the variable. We treat this as one variable, 3x squared minus 1, to the power, the original exponent of this quantity, 3x squared minus 1 is negative 3 minus 1. We subtract 1 from minus 3. We write minus 3 minus 1. And now we apply the chain rule by multiplying this by the derivative of 3x squared minus 1. We apply the chain rule because this base, when we apply the power rule to this expression, the base is not just a single variable, but a function of x. So after we get this product, we multiply that by the derivative of 3x squared minus 1. And the derivative of 3x squared is by differentiation rule for the product of a constant and a function is equal to the constant 3 multiplied by the derivative of x squared by power rule is equal to the exponent 2 multiplied by 2 we write the that notation for multiplication so that we will not be confused with the operation multiplication x and the variable x. We have 3 times the derivative of x squared. Derivative of x squared equals the exponent 2 multiplied by the variable x to the power, the original exponent is 2 minus 1. Minus the derivative of 1 because 1 is a constant, its derivative is 0. Hence, minus derivative of 1, 0. Minus 0. And we simplify. We multiply the numerical constants or the numerical coefficients. We have negative 3 by, we have 2 outside. Multiply by negative 3 by positive 3 is negative 9. Multiply by 3x squared. Sorry. You cannot multiply negative 3 by 3 because this is not just a single term. We have a binomial. We have negative 3. Negative 3 multiplied by 3x squared minus 1 to the power negative 3 minus 1 is negative 4 multiplied by 3 by 2 is 6 multiplied by x to the power 2 minus 1 is 1 or we simply write x and 6x, this is 6x minus 0 is 6x. We simplify further. Now we multiply the numerical constants. 6 by negative 3 is negative 18. Multiply by positive 2, that's negative 36. Negative 36x multiplied by quantity 3x squared minus 1. To the power negative 4. And as we said earlier, we remove all the negative exponents in the final answer. Thus, we bring this in the denominator. In the numerator, we are left with negative 36x over. When we bring this in the denominator, we take the opposite sign of negative 4. And we get quantity 3x squared minus 1 to the power 4. Which is similar to the answer we obtained earlier. But in the first solution, we let u be equal to 3x squared minus 1. But in this solution, we did not make use of the variable u. We applied directly the chain rule and the power rule to this expression. We just remember that whenever you get the derivative of 3x squared minus 1 to the power negative 3, you multiply it by the derivative of 3x squared minus 1. And we get the same solution, the derivative of y equals 2 over quantity 3x squared minus 1 to the power 3. Is equal to negative 36x over quantity 3x squared minus 1 to the power 4. For our last example, consider the following. Find y prime. Again, we find the derivative of y with respect to the independent variable. In number 5, the independent variable is x. Hence, we get the derivative of y with respect to x. and y equals x squared multiplied by e to the x. In the given function, we have a product of x squared and e to the x, and we treat each factor as separate function. We take x squared as one function and e to the x as another function. Thus, we take x squared as the function f and e to the x as the function g. Thus, the given function y is a product of two functions f and g, where f is x squared and g is e to the x. And to get the derivative of the product of two functions f and g, we apply the product rule. The product rule says the derivative of the product of two functions f and g, denoted by y prime, is equal to the function f multiplied by the derivative of g plus the function g multiplied by the derivative of f. We now get the derivative of y equals x squared multiplied by e to the x by applying the product rule. Derivative of y denoted by y prime equals f. Our f is x squared multiplied by derivative of g. Our g is e to the x, and the derivative of e to the x we had earlier is itself e to the x multiplied by e to the x. Again, y prime equals f. F is x squared multiplied by g prime, that is derivative of g. Our g is e to the x, and the derivative of e to the x, or g prime, is e to the x plus g. Our function g is e to the x multiplied by derivative of f. Our f is x squared, and to get the derivative of x squared, we apply the power rule, where the exponent n in the power rule is 2. Derivative of x squared is n, the exponent of x, 2. Multiply by the variable to the power n minus 1. Our n here is 2 minus 1. And we simplify y prime equals x squared e to the x plus 2 times e to the x multiply by x raised to 2 minus 1 is 1. So the exponent of x is 1, but we simply write x, and it is customary again that we write the final answer in factored form. You can see that in these two terms, the common factors are x. Both terms contain x, and e to the x is also a common factor. Hence, derivative of y in factored form is x. Common factor is x, but we take the lower exponent of x. Between the exponents 2 and 1 of x, the lower exponent is 1. So we factor out x. And both terms contain e to the x, so e to the x is a common factor. And we find the other factor by dividing each term by the common factor. X squared divided by x is x. E to the x divided by e to the x is 1. Multiplied by x is x plus x divided by x is 1. E to the x divided by e to the x is 1. Multiplied by 2 is 2. Hence, this is the derivative of the function, the product of x squared times e to the x. denoted by y prime in factored form is equal to x times e to the x times quantity x plus 2. For your practice, please try the following exercises. Exercises, find y prime. To find y prime is to get the derivative of the given function by applying one or more of the differentiation rules we have stated at the beginning of this lesson. But not all of them, we have not taken all of those differentiation rules because we will continue with the other differentiation rules in the next lesson. But for now, you try to get the derivative of the following functions denoted by y prime. In number one, y is a function of m. So y prime is derivative of y with respect to m. In the first problem, you will apply the differentiation rules for the product or sum of for the sum or difference of two functions. The differentiation rule for the product of a constant and a function, and the differentiation, the power rule, and also the derivative, the rule for the derivative of a constant. Number two, y is a function of h. Hence, y prime is the derivative of y with respect to h. In number two, you will apply the chain rule and the power rule. You may let u equals 5h plus 1 and then apply the chain rule and the power rule. Or you may go directly apply the chain rule to get the derivative of 5h plus 1 to the power 6. In number 3, y is a function of x. But y is a product of x cubed multiplied by e to the x. The function y is a function of x cubed and e to the x. You take this as the function f and take this as the function g and apply the product rule. In number 4, we have a similar example, an example similar to number 4. We have y equals negative of 9 over quantity t cubed plus 2t squared. To, as I said earlier, that we can apply the quotient rule for this problem, but we have not taken an example for applying the quotient rule. So what you will do, you bring this quantity t cubed plus 2t squared in the numerator. You take the opposite sign of 2 and apply the chain rule and power rule. If you have question about the lesson today, you ask your question in the comments below. And do not forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thank you for joining me in this lesson today.